بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his last messenger. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon him. Dear viewers, welcome to the best of knowledge. The scholars have said that the best of knowledge is the knowledge that will enable you to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. The knowledge that will enable you to know your Lord the most. And in this series, we will be talking about the mightness and the greatness and the mercy and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In each episode we'll be talking about one of Allah's exalted attributes, and we will ponder on its impact on our lives, and we will reflect upon its impact on our lives and how we should conduct ourselves in the light of this attribute. And today we'll be talking, inshallah, about the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described himself to be the all-knower. The all-knower. The one who owns the knowledge. Allah ta'ala said, فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah ta'ala, O Muhammad, Allah your Lord will suffice you against their plan, against their plot. فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah Ta'ala will suffice you against them. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And He is the all-hearer and He is the all-knower. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Furthermore, Allah's knowledge encompasses everything. Allah Ta'ala encompasses everything with His knowledge. Allah Ta'ala said, إنما إلهكم الله الذي لا إله إلا هو. Your Lord is Allah. There is no deity worthy of worship but Him. وسع كل شيء علما. Who embraced everything with His knowledge. Allah Ta'ala embraced everything with His knowledge. Allah Ta'ala in the other verse He said as well, ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما. O Allah, You have encompassed everything with Your mercy and Your knowledge. فَاغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا. So Allah, forgive those who repent to You, those who return to You. O Allah, forgive them. O Allah, bestow Your mercy upon them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has the knowledge of everything. Allah Ta'ala knows all of our actions and all of our deeds, and we cannot be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows our deeds and our actions. And Allah Ta'ala told us about the people who thought that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is heedless about them. The wrongdoers. Allah Ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ تَتَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Those whom the angels caused them to die or took their souls. ظالمي أنفسهم. While they are wrong, they are doing wrong to themselves. While they are committing sins. فألقوا السلام. Those people will show full submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will show a full submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then they will say, ما كنا نعمل من سوء. Oh Allah, we never done any wrongdoing, any wrong action. Allah Ta'ala will reply, بَلَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Indeed, Allah Ta'ala is fully aware. Allah Ta'ala knows everything that you should do. Allah Ta'ala knows all of our actions. Allah Ta'ala knows our deeds, He knows our actions, and He knows our secrets. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala in the Quran said, أَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ. Can't they comprehend that Allah Ta'ala knows their secrets Allah Ta'ala knows our secrets. And our najwa, which is our secret consultation, Allah Ta'ala knows it. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ Allah Ta'ala is the knower of all hidden things. Allah knows everything. Nothing can be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even what we hide inside our chests, Allah Ta'ala is aware of it. Allah Ta'ala knows it. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, قُلْ إِن تُخْفُوا مَا فِي صُدُورِكُمْ Whether you conceal that which is inside your hearts, inside your chests, whether you conceal it, whether you hide it or reveal it. أَوْ تُبْدُوهُ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ Allah Ta'ala knows it. Whether you do, whether you conceal it or reveal it, Allah Ta'ala is fully aware of it. قُلْ إِن تُخْفُوا مَا فِي صُدُورِكُمْ أَوْ تُبْدُوهُ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ And he knows everything in the heaven and everything on earth. He knows everything in his universe. Nothing in his universe can be moved or can change its position unless if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permits. Allah ta'ala knows the movement of all of his creations, regardless of their sizes, regardless of their volumes. Allah ta'ala, when he spoke about the sun and the stars and the moons, Allah ta'ala said, وَالشَّمْسُ تَجْرِي لِمُسْتَقَرٍ لَهَا And the sun is running in an orbit that has been set for it. ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ And this is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the All-Knower. So the sun is moving under Allah's knowledge. Allah knows everything about His creation. Even the leaf of a tree, when it drops from the tree, in the darkness of the forest, Allah knows about it. Even that small leaf, Allah Ta'ala knows about it. Although it is in the darkness of the forest, Allah Ta'ala knows about it. Even the grain in the mid of the earth, Allah knows about that particular grain. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ To Allah belong the keys of the unseen. لا يعلمها إلا هو No one knows them but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ He knows everything in the sea and everything on earth. Nothing is hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا And no a leaf were to be dropped from a tree unless Allah ta'ala is aware of it. Allah knows everything about His creation. وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ And even the grain in the midst of the earth, Allah Ta'ala, in the midst of the darkness of the earth, Allah Ta'ala knows it. And Allah Ta'ala is aware of it. وَلَا رَطْبٍ وَلَا يَابِسٍ And everything which is wet or dry, Allah knows it. إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ And everything is written in a clear book. Everything is known to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And nothing is hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows everything about His creations. And they cannot hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ Can't he know what he has created? وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ And he is all gentle. And they're all aware. He knows everything about his creations. Allah Ta'ala in the verse of the chair, the kursi, spoke about his knowledge. He said, يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ Allah knows everything about his creations. Everything about people. He knows about their history. He knows about the present. He knows about the future. He knows what is before them and what is after them. And we are all within the capsule of Allah's knowledge. Allah knows everything about us. And we cannot be hidden or we cannot hide ourselves from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows everything about us. He knows our movements. And He knows our actions. He knows our secrets. And He knows what we hide in our chests. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one occasion, He said to Jibreel alayhi salam, to Jibreel, the angel, said to him, "Oh Jibreel, can't you come to us more time and more frequently?" Jibreel alayhi salam replied to him saying, "وَمَا نَتَنَزَّلُ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ" "Oh Muhammad, we as angels, we cannot move, we cannot do anything unless if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permits, unless with the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot do anything. لَهُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِينَا" "He owns everything before us and everything behind us." وَمَا خَلْفَنَا وَمَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ and everything which is in between of those two, meaning ourselves, the angels, Allah Ta'ala owns us. وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ نَسِيًّا oh Muhammad, your Lord was never forgetful. Allah knows everything and is aware of everything. And how to conduct ourselves in light of this attribute, the knowledge of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. First of all, we should be always aware that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is overwatching us. Allah ta'ala, He has the knowledge about us. He knows everything about our actions. And the moment that we think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is heedless about us, we will be committing a very serious mistake. And that mistake, it might throw us in the hellfire. Allah ta'ala in the Quran, when He spoke to when he addressed the wrongdoing, the wrongdoers, Allah Ta'ala said, وَمَا كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَتِرُونَ You never thought that your limbs or your hearing or your sight will testify against you. وَمَا كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَتِرُونَ أَنْ يَشْهَدَ عَلَيْكُمْ سَمْعُكُمْ وَلَا أَبْصَارُكُمْ وَلَا جُلُودُكُمْ You never thought that they will testify against you. ولكن ظننتم أن الله لا يعلم You thought Allah Ta'ala is not aware of many of your actions. أن الله لا يعلم كثيرا مما تعملون You thought Allah Ta'ala is not aware of many of your actions. And that thought threw you in the hellfire. وذلكم ظنكم الذي ظننتم بربكم And that thought threw you in the hellfire and he became from the losers. Because you thought Allah Ta'ala is not aware of many of your actions. And also we should know that Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is aware of everything and nothing is hidden from Him, Tabaraka wa Taqaddas. And therefore, whenever Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala commands us to do something, then we should realize that it is better for us. It is better for us. And His legislation, His commandment, His law is better than everything because He knows better than us. And this is an impact of believing and in submitting to this noble attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the all-knowledgeable or the all-knower. Oh Allah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit from this reminder and ask Allah ta'ala to increase our knowledge and to increase our iman and see you inshallah next time. On the best of knowledge, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.